Hi, welcome back to the series where I'm building a social network for puppies. Sounds kind of ridiculous, so bear with me because in this episode, we are going to tackle the issue of deployment. Now, to quickly recap our last ep, we just set up our Phoenix application with Tailwind CSS and then styled our homepage, so nothing too crazy. And we really want to tackle the kind of issue of getting our application up and running on some production server. And to do that, I'll be using Mix and Heroku. Now, there's some timestamps down below, so if you want to go ahead and skip straight to the content and see how we actually do the deploy, then feel free to do so. But before I jump in, I want to talk about why I chose Mix and Heroku. Now, there's lots of ways that you can deploy a Phoenix application, and that's not a bad thing, but for me, it definitely led to some analysis paralysis. And I wanted to talk through some of the context that I had, just in case you were in a similar situation. I wanted something that was fast, straightforward to deploy, and free, mainly free. So that's why I ended up going with Mix and Heroku. Now, there are definitely some trade-offs with Heroku. For example, the Heroku instances don't stay up and running all the time. They come down after a little while. So, you know, if you have anything in like an ETS table or a gen server, that's just gonna stop running at some point. And there's also limited connections, and that's just to name a few of the trade-offs. Now, this idea of trade-offs was really what I had to keep in mind when I was making these decisions on which deployment method to use. Because I talked about Mix quite a lot, so let's kind of dig into that a little bit more. So using Mix Deploy, what I really mean is I'm taking my source code from a local machine or from GitHub, and then I'm uploading that to a production server. So in our instance, it's going to be on some Heroku instance. And then I'll be running a Mix command, and because it's a Phoenix application, I'll be running Mix Phoenix.server to get our application running in production. Now, one of the trade-offs here is it's going to be slower startup time because I'm kind of uploading like the whole application onto a production server. Also going to have your source code on production, which may or may not be a good thing because if someone gets access to the production instance and they have access to source code, potentially could be bad. But because I'm just learning, it's really nice to be able to run Mix commands in my production instance. Beyond Mix, there's also Elixir releases and tools like Distillery. So Elixir releases came into Elixir in 1.9. And with Elixir releases, you can use a Mix command, which is Mix release, to compile your Elixir application and bring it down to some unit that you can upload to any production server. And that's pretty cool because that kind of single unit has everything you need to run your Elixir app. So you don't need to install Elixir or Erlang on that production server. You can just start a command with that package and it'll run everything for you. But it does mean that you have to have more configuration with your Elixir release. You kind of have to specify a few more commands. You don't have access to Mix, so you know, you might have to change a few things. At least you have to change more than what you would have had to change with just Mix. Finally, with tools like Distillery, has a lot of similarities with Elixir releases, but it supports older Elixir applications. So from 1.6 onwards, it kind of supported those old apps, which is really great. So if you're kind of looking for a tool that deals with those types of applications, you probably need something like Distillery. And it also gives hot code upgrades, so you can upgrade your application on the fly, so you don't need to bring down your server to actually update the code, which is crazy. I actually have no idea how to do that, but super impressive. And I guess you just have to keep in mind that there are probably some distillery related configuration that you'll need. And it's not, you know, it's a third party library. So beyond these deployment methods, there's also a bunch of places to host your application. So I mentioned Heroku, there's also Gig Elixir, which is kind of like Heroku, but for Elixir applications. And that's definitely a great tool. Go check it out. It has a really generous free tier, but it only allows one instance on that free tier. So I can't have multiple Elixir applications, which was kind of my limiting factor there. But there's also, you know, any other cloud hosting platform will be able to host an Elixir application. So like DigitalOcean, Render is another one, even AWS, especially if you use something like Elixir releases where you can just package up your application, you can really run that anywhere. So hopefully that little bit of context helped. I'm sure there's a lot more discussion to be had, especially if you're running an Elixir application at scale. Like this is just a kind of like a toy app almost, so I don't really have great answers for that, but I've definitely rambled on for way too long. So let's just jump into actually deploying our application. Okay, since we are deploying our application on Heroku, we first need to add some build packs. So we're going to create a new Heroku app using the #nuke Elixir build pack. Let's also take note of the app name, Thawing Temple 13642. And then next, we'll also want to add a Phoenix build pack. So using this command, we can add the Phoenix build pack, and then we can see that we have a list of build packs added, which is great because this order actually matters. Now, the reason the order actually matters is because the Phoenix build pack will run a different command, which is our mix phoenix.server command. Now, we could have just used the original Elixir build pack, and that would run a different command, which would be mix run no halt. And we would have to kind of tell Heroku which command to run using a proc file, but we can kind of avoid doing all of that by just kind of using the Phoenix build pack. Now that we have our build pack installed, let's open up our code and add a couple of new files. First off, we'll add the elixir-buildpack.config file, and this is where we are going to define our Elixir version, which is 1.11.3, and our Erlang version, which is 23.2.4. Now, I'm using ASDF, so I can check this by using ASDF current, and I can get my versions that way. And now going back to our code, we're also going to add a Phoenix static buildpack. Now, obviously, if I could type, it'd make it a little easier. And in this config file, we're going to define our node version, and this node version is what will be run using our Phoenix buildpack. And I'm using node 15.4.0. So after adding the configs, let's switch over to prod.exx. We're going to replace this line that says URL host example, and we're going to replace it with some Heroku specific information. Now, this few lines are copied from the Heroku deployment guides, and we're just going to replace the host name with our app, Heroku app name, which is Thawing Temple, also with the numbers as well, and we're just going to copy paste it there, and it should be good. Next, in our prod secret.exx, we're going to uncomment out this SSL true line, and that's all we really need to do in this file. And then in our endpoint.ex, we are going to add a timeout on our WebSockets. So here we are just going to add timeout 45,000. And again, this information is also found in the Phoenix deployment guides, which are really great, and I'll link that down in the description below. And that is all we need to do with our code. So we are going to add on a Heroku Postgres database using this command. And then from there, we're going to increase our pool size as well to 18. Now, Heroku actually supports up to 20, but we don't want to use the whole pool. We want to get something as close as we can to it. And that is it for kind of the database setup. So now we need to set up our secrets. So let's run a mix command, mix phoenix.gen.secret, and then we are going to copy this information and set it as a production environment variable in Heroku using this Heroku config set secret key base. Now, after setting the secret in Heroku, we are going to push everything to Git. So we have a bunch of files that we've changed. Let's add them. Let's make a commit for them. I'll say testing like Heroku deploy, and then from there I'm just gonna first push to our main branch, and then we are also going to push to the Heroku main branch, and this will get our app deployed in Heroku. Now this is going to take a little while to run, so I'm gonna jump to when it's all finished. Great, so that upload is all finished. Now we can open up our app and see it running in production. So we can use this Heroku open command, and this will pop open our app in Chrome. And great, there's our Sniff social app that we have been working on in the last episode. That's the homepage that we styled. And you see that there's puppy pictures, we have the search bar and everything's there. And then our URL is this Thawing Temple URL. And that's our kind of production URL that Heroku gives us. Now, this is great and all, you know, we can git push Heroku main and then we can get our app updated, but it would be really nice if anytime we push to just our GitHub origin main branch, it would automatically deploy. So let's get that set up in Heroku. Let's switch over to our Heroku dashboard. We are going to go find our app, which is down here, Thawing Temple. We can see this is our dashboard for it. And to connect everything up, it's under deploy, and we can connect directly to GitHub. And here we can just select our repo name, which is Sniff Social, and see it connects here. And then once this is all kind of connected in Heroku, we can scroll down a little bit and turn on automatic deploys using this kind of big button here. There's an option here to wait for CI to pass before deploy. Now, we definitely want to get CI set up, but we don't really have that many tests or any kind of useful tests. So let's get some tests running in the next episode, and then we can get CI up and running then. Now, let's switch back to our code and let's make a change and push it up to main. So we're just going to go back to our kind of homepage index.html template. And you know, we're just going to add some text here just to test kind of the deploy. So maybe after the sniff social, we'll just add like automatic deploy, save that file, and then we're going to commit this change. So here we can see that we only have one file changed. We can add this file and then commit it again with some like arbitrary message, like a test automatic deploy by changing header. And then we are just going to git push, and this will just push our branch to origin main, and we don't need to worry about doing a git push to Heroku main. Now, if we switch back over to our Heroku dashboard here, and then head over to the activity tab, we can see that we have a build in progress. So this kind of automatically kicked off when we did a git push to main, which is what we just set up in the previous step. So here, a bunch of stuff is going to compile. I am going to cut here and we'll just jump to when it's all completed. Great, so this is all done with the deploy. You can see it's been released. And if we switch back over to our prod URL, refresh the page, we can see that our automatic deploy text appears. So everything seems to be working. Okay, that's it. So we have our application up and running in Heroku. We've turned on automated deploys as well. So anytime we push to main, our application gets automatically rebuilt via Heroku, and we can see our production gets updated automatically. So that's all very exciting. Now, in the next episode, which I'm much more excited about, we are going to kind of get into the meat of building Sniff Social. So I'll be setting up authentication, going to be setting up a user model, and then I'll be adding some puppies to the application as well. So stay tuned, hit that subscribe button, I guess, if you want to stay tuned, and I will see you next time.